Now let us see the fifth chapter, working with Windows 7. We see the topic, handling the mouse. So what are the, first of all, we have to learn about mouse and its action. So what the first action is point to an item. What is point to an item? Move the mouse pointer over the item. Next one, click. That is left mouse click, left click. Point to the item on the screen. Press and release the left mouse button. And the third one is right click. What is right click? Point to the item on the screen and press and release the right mouse button. If you are clicking the right mouse button, what happens? It displays a pop-up menu with various options. And then fourth one is double click. Double click means what? Point to the item on the screen and quickly press twice the left mouse button. That is called double click. And next one is drag and drop. Point to that item, then hold the leftmost button. As you move the pointer, when you have reached the desired position, release the mouse button. That is the drag and drop. So this is an important question for 3 mark or 5 mark. Okay. So what are the mouse actions we are studying? Point to an item, click, right click, double click and drag and drop. The next topic is Windows Desktop. So what is desktop? The opening screen of Windows is called desktop. So in desktop, desktop shows the start button, taskbar, notification area in the taskbar and date and time. So here one more option, arrow big. See the picture, arrow big button. What is the use of arrow big button? You can move to the desktop anytime by pressing this icon, this arrow big icon, while working in any application. Next we see the topic, icons. So see, there are a lot of icons are there now. What is icon? It is a graphic symbol representing the window elements like files, folders, shortcuts, etc. So what is icon? It is a graphic symbol representing the window elements like files, folders, shortcuts, etc. So we are seeing lot of icons now. So first of all, we see the standard icons, which are called as standard icons. The icons which are available on desktop by default while installing Windows OS. By default while installing the Windows OS, the icon, some icons are default available. So that are called as standard icons. So what are the standard icons available in all Windows OS? My computer, documents and recycle bin. And the next one, shortcut icons. Shortcut icons. The shortcut icons can be created for any application or file or folder. How you can create the shortcut? By right clicking, and then by right clicking any application, we have to create any shortcut icons. So by double clicking that icon, the related application or file or folder will open. The next topic is disk drive icons. So what are the disk drive icons we are seeing? The first one is hard disk. Hard disk means the local disk C colon, D colon, E colon are called as hard disk. And then next one, CD-ROM or DVD drive. And then next one, removable pen drive option. And then next one, other removable storage such as mobile, smartphone and tablet, etc. And the last one is network drives. If your system is connected with the other system, this network drives will be used. So the next topic is the window. So what is a window? Window is a typical rectangular area in an application or a document. What is window? It is a typical rectangular area in an application or a document. So the application window. What is application window? It is an area on a computer screen with defined boundaries and within which information is displayed. See the screen, the full application that see the picture, the whole screen that will be the up An application window contains an open application, that is current application such as Word or Paint. So when two or more windows are open, what happen? Only one of them is active and the rest are inactive. So next one is document window. See this white screen, the section, the see the picture, that inside the picture, the application work area, that is called document window. So a document window is a section of the screen used to display the contents of a document. So next we see the next topic, elements of a window. Suppose if you are opening an application like OpenOffice Writer, so this is a window. So what is the, what are the elements of a window here? There are five elements are there: title bar, menu bar, the workspace, scroll bars and corners and borders. So the first, see the screen, the first one is title bar. What is the title bar is the topmost bar. Have you seen the topmost bar? That is the title bar. So title bar display the name of the application and name of the document opened. So what is the name of the application? If you are still open, if you are not saved that application, so untitled one is a application name. And what is the name of the document open? OpenOffice Writer. So it can also contain minimize, maximize and close button. And the next one is menu bar. Next one is menu bar. So the menu bar is see under the title bar. So if you are see the menu bar, if you are in Windows 7, in the absence of menu bar, what happen? If you are moved to computer, my computer icon, and then the in that computer icon we have to click the organize button. From the drop down menu, click the layout option and select the desired item, that is menu bar. Okay, from layout we have to click the menu bar, then the menu bar will be shown. So in the absence of menu bar, you have to click organize layout and then you click the menu bar button. And the next one is the workspace, that white background workspace area. No, see the picture, workspace. So in the workspace, what happened? It is the area in the document window to enter or type the text of your document. You have to type. And then next one, scroll bar. So the scroll bars are used to scroll the workspace horizontally and vertically. See that horizontal scroll bar and also vertical scroll bars are there. And the next one is corners and borders. Corners and borders. The corners and borders of the window helps to drag and resize the window. Drag and resize the window. So the mouse pointer has been changed to double headed arrow when positioned over a border or corner. So you have to drag. The window can be resized. We have to, by dragging the corners diagonally across the screen, the windows can be resized, either small or you have to big. So that's all.